The disposal of radioactive waste is more topical than ever in Switzerland. We've been working on safe solutions for more than 40 years. The risk involved in keeping high-level radioactive waste at the surface is much too high in the long term, because the waste stays radioactive for several hundreds of thousands or even up to a million years. This is why we need a deep geological repository. The Nagra cooperative was set up for a specific purpose. The producers of radioactive waste in Switzerland have assigned us the task of planning and developing safe waste management solutions and ultimately making these a reality. In theory, the functioning of a deep geological repository is very straightforward. The high-level waste is transported in disposal containers via a rail system to a depth of around 600 meters. The containers are then unloaded to the emplacement tunnel in the opalinous clay host rock, and the tunnel is backfilled with a granular bentonite mixture. The backfill has to be as tight and homogeneous as possible. In order to achieve the highest possible degree of safety in practice, we've developed what we call a multiple barrier concept. These are the spent fuel assemblies, which come from the nuclear power plants. They're placed in the first barrier. This is the container, which is made of steel, very thick steel. The second barrier is the bentonite, consisting of blocks and a granular bentonite mixture. The third barrier is the host rock, in this case the opalinous clay. The opalinous clay has very special properties. It's around 175 million years old, and here time practically stands still. We have made theoretical predictions of system behavior based on model calculations. Now we have to check these theories in practice. In the Grono facility in Canton Graubünden, a test run for the experiment was carried out. This involves placing a container in a full-scale model of an emplacement tunnel and using the prototype backfilling machine to backfill the tunnel with a granular bentonite mixture. The granular bentonite is a mixture of clay minerals. These clay minerals have the ability to swell on contact with water. They increase in volume and form a tight barrier around the containers. We fill the granular bentonite mixture, you can see it here, into this hopper. It is fed through the auger conveyor here into this distribution system. The mixture is divided among the five long augers and transported forwards through them. It is then filled horizontally into the tunnel as tightly and homogeneously as possible. In the next stage of the project, the backfilling machine will be moved to the Mont Terri rock laboratory, where it will be used to backfill a 50-meter-long tunnel with three dummy containers. National and international experiments are carried out in the Mont Terri rock laboratory. Swiss Topo is the facility operator. We review the concepts of the research partners and monitor whether the work is carried out in accordance with safety regulations. The Commission de Suivi is responsible for ensuring that the experiments are carried out in line with the defined guidelines. Thanks to this experiment, we know firstly that disposal tunnels can be constructed in the opalinous clay. Secondly, that the heavy containers can be placed accurately in a relatively narrow space in the tunnel. And thirdly, that the tunnels can be backfilled tightly to the required standard with granular bentonite. High-level waste and spent fuel assemblies produce heat. Heater elements were therefore installed in the containers to simulate the heat output of the waste. Both the tunnel and the containers are equipped with more than 1,000 measurement points. This is actually the centerpiece of the experiment. In the coming years, the measured data will be used to show that the predictions and the calculations correspond in practice. The project team is extremely proud to have achieved the transition from paper planning to reality. We've put our heart and soul into the details of this project and are proud to see this prototype functioning here. There is still a long way to go before a deep geological repository is realized. The path is not only challenging in technical terms, but many political and social hurdles also have to be overcome.